While visiting Northwest Georgia, we had the good fortune to meet Mr. Steve Tony, the chief bugler of the 28th Georgian Division of the Civil War reenactors. They were doing a reenactment at the Alatoona Pass battlefield. Bugler Tony explained the origins of the bugle call Taps, and he will explain how it has a direct relationship to the financial organization American Express.
In 1862, General Butterfield was a brigade commander in the Army of the Potomac under General McClellan. They had just fought the 7 days battles. The Federal Army had gone up all the way to the gates of Richmond. Lee had taken command. The Confederates pushed the Federal Army back. And after 7 days of intense fighting, the Federal Army retreated back to a place called Harrison's Landing on the James Peninsula. And at this location, General Butterfield was at a place called Berkeley Plantation. And during that 7 days of fighting, General Butterfield's brigade alone lost over 600 men. So while they were recuperating at this location, General Butterfield decided he didn't like the last call of the day. And up until then, it was called to extinguish lights, and it sounded like this. General Butterfield thought that sounded too militaristic to be the last call. He wanted something a little more somber than that. So what he did, he took his brigade bugler, Oliver Wilcox Norton, and then took the 1835 infantry manual and had Norton play the last eight measures of the call tattoo. As Norton would play it, General Butterfield would lengthen notes, shorten notes, change it a little bit, got it the way he wanted it, and then had Norton write it down, and then had Norton play it that night. Well, Norton recorded that the next day, other brigade buglers came up and asked him what was that call that he played. So he gave them the music, they began playing it, and eventually spread it throughout the Federal Army. Well, the Confederates could hear it across the James River, and they began playing it as well, and it spread throughout the Confederate Army. Does anybody know which this new call was called?
Taps.
It was Taps. You're absolutely right. It was written in 1862. In July of 1862 at Berkeley Plantation. So if you go there today, there's a monument up. In fact, this summer was the 150th anniversary of the birthplace of Taps. They had big celebrations there. This was in July. In August of 1862, a federal artillery battery had lost one of its members in battle. And instead of firing the traditional volleys over the man's grave, the commanding officer thought that might bring on a general engagement with the enemy. So instead, he had his artillery bugler play this new call, Taps, that had been spreading throughout the Army instead. So that was the very first time Taps was ever played at the military funeral, and it did not become an officially part of the military funeral until 1873. In 1892, Taps was slightly modified by the Commandant of the U.S. Marine Corps Band, whom you might know as John Philip Sousa. And a lot of people today still play the incorrect Sousa version, but the military plays it note for note the way General Butterfield composed it in 1862. So here then is the new version of To Extinguish Lights, also known as Taps. Origin of Taps were basically forgotten following the Civil War until 1898, when a magazine editor from New York wrote an article on the origins of bugle calls. So he talked about all the calls, mostly coming from the French. He said there was one call, he didn't know where it came from, it was called Taps, so he figured it must have come from the French as well. About 2 weeks later, he received a letter from a Chicago businessman by the name of Oliver Wilcox Norton, who told him not only did he know where the call came from, but he was there when it was written. And so he went on to tell him the story of General Butterfield and the origins of Taps. Well, the magazine editor contacted General Butterfield in upstate New York, sent him a copy of Norton's letter, who was Butterfield's brigade bugler, and Butterfield confirmed that what Norton said was exactly what happened. And if anyone's a student of the Battle of Gettysburg, during that battle in 1863, it was Butterfield's original brigade that defended Little Round Top. And on top of Little Round Top was Oliver Wilcox Norton, the chief bugler for that brigade, during that entire fighting. And one of the definitive books written about the Battle of Gettysburg and Little Round Top was written by Oliver Wilcox Norton. It's called The Attack and Defense of Little Round Top. So it's the number one eyewitness account of that part of the battle. And that was written by General Butterfield's brigade bugler, who was also the very first person to ever play taps. Well, here's a little trivia for you. Prior to the war, General Butterfield worked for his dad's stagecoach company. His dad's name was John Butterfield. And at that time, the stagecoach industry was highly competitive. So their niche in the market was they ran a stagecoach line from St. Louis to San Francisco. And it was called the Overland Express Company. And Dan Butterfield worked as the Eastern Superintendent. He had an office in New York. When the Civil War broke out, he left his job, joined the Federal Army, rose to the rank of Brigadier General. After the war ended, General Butterfield went back to his same office in New York, resumed his same duties as the Eastern Superintendent. Well, the company grew. They bought other companies. They were eventually bought by Wells Fargo, at which point they changed their name from the Overland Express Company to the American Express Company. Well, they're still in business today, or the last I heard, they were no longer running a stagecoach line. But the next time you use your American Express card, think about General Butterfield, the origins of Taps.
We would especially like to thank Lori Rowe Communications, the Cartersville, Georgia Convention and Visitors Bureau, and Mr. Steve Toney, Chief Bugler of the 28th Georgian Division of Civil War Reenactors, for this opportunity to bring you the origins of the bugle call, Taps.